Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Lisa Grill and you are watching the Most Non-Random channel on YouTube. Nothing happens accidentally, and if you are here, you really need the information I'm going to talk about. Let's start with my first video, because there you can find out how does fasting work, what is it, what are the benefits of fasting, and here is a link. And this video is about my own experience and three methods of fasting: on water, without water, dry fasting, and fasting by Marva Oganyan on herbs. I'm really excited because I'm going to blow your mind today and tell some things which are unbelievable, but I swear I'm telling you only truth. You may not believe, the choice is yours, but I have no reasons to lie. So hi-ho, let's go! It was 2014 and I was living in Vietnam, Nha Trang, for about 6 months and eating almost only mango, because it was a try to become a fruitarian or a breatharian, I don't remember exactly. And at that moment I was on a raw, very strict vegan nutrition for about 6 months. And I was feeling excellent, satisfied with hot climate of Vietnam after cold Russia, and swimming in the sea whenever I wanted. Tasting exotic fruits and many different types of mango, which still remains my favorite fruit. In Vietnam, I tried a dry type of fasting and I learned a very curious thing about exactly dry fasting without water, other liquids and food. And it's a real fact. I won't be telling you some scientific terms like autolysis, exogenous and endogenous water and ketoacidotic crisis, not to confuse you so much. I will explain the most important mechanism, how does it work. The main fact is that even 1 day of dry fasting without any water from the outside has the effect for our body equal to 3 days fasting on water. The reason is that during dry fasting we are facing detox crisis much more faster than on water. It's time when you are facing some exacerbation of your chronic diseases, and this is a turning point in every fasting, when the body can't receive any food from the outside and it goes to the nutrition by the expense of our internal resources. During this period, treatment of our body begins, incomparable with any medication. You can feel a strong weakness, nausea and even vomiting appears, headaches, dizziness, blackouts, and the weight loss stops, red appears on your tongue, and sometimes you can feel something similar to the smell of acetone from your skin. But of course, it's not a must. It depends on what was the intoxication of your body, how dirty your body was. And after the detox crisis, you can feel relief and a lot of energy appears. In Vietnam, I made 1 day of dry fasting, but it was very terrible and tough because of tropical hot climates of Vietnam. And I felt so thirsty, like I was in the desert and I wanted to drink a bucket of water. And of course, it was too fast to face any changes in my body. But after half of a year, I came back to Moscow. It was November and started snowing. I had a good chance to try my first long fasting, and of course it was a dry one. I read several books about fasting, and most of them are in Russian, but I will again leave a link for those in English, which I could find on Amazon. I saw different persons on YouTube who shared their experiences of dry fasting, and even I saw a video diary of one man who made 19 days of dry fasting, walking out in hard frost, almost naked and barefooted. Crazy Russian man. But of course, this fact inspired me a lot, and I decided to start my dry fasting for 7 days. But the mild type, with the possibility to contact water, to take bath and gargling. After dry fasting, I planned 4 days on water, 4 days on natural juices. You know, every person who knows something about fasting will tell you that it's vitally important to enter fasting correctly and go out of fasting as long as your fasting lasted, or even 2 times longer. Because you know, many people after long austerity start eating everything like crazy, and it's deadly. I heard one story about a man who, after 30 days on water, came to an Italian restaurant and ate 3 servings of pasta. And he got a twist of intestines and unfortunately died. So be very careful. The first thing I've done to begin my dry fasting is colon cleanse made with this beautiful thing. It's enema or douchebag. Or it's also called the mug of Esmarch. No matter how it's called, but you can find it in any pharmacy nearby. And here I want to stop a little bit longer because it's a really important thing. Now there are numerous disputes about whether it's useful or harmful to clean your intestines. And the fact is that there are thousands of microorganisms living in your intestines. They are involved in the process of digestion. And theoretically, they are washed out during this cleansing and are very difficult to recover. On the other hand, if the human's body and intestines were heavily clogged, the intestinal microflora is also not so super balanced or even harmful, and many parasites are living there. Do not believe? Check it out! So something came out of me and it was very disgusting. I will tell you about this later. My opinion is that it's necessary to cleanse the intestines. Otherwise, your fasting will be unbearable because toxins will enter your blood and intestines and you will be feeling very weak and you can even faint. Okay, we finished with this. And now I want to explain how we are cleansing our intestines. The day we begin our fasting, we're eating only fruit and drink natural juices. At 5 p.m. we start drinking only water, and at 7 p.m. we're starting our cleansing. I guess you should take vacations at your job for this procedure or start on weekends at least. Point first, leave this evening free because you won't be able to communicate with people, believe me. And don't risk to go outdoors. Point second, prepare a hot warming pan or any warmer you have at home. My Anima is a transformer and it has function of warmer as well, but you can use simply a bottle filled with hot water. Point three, after the warmer is prepared, it's necessary to drink a glass of warm boiled water in which magnesium sulfate is dissolved. For each 10 kilograms of your body weight, you need 10 grams of magnesium sulfate. I heard it's also so-called British salt. So if I weigh, for example, 50 kilograms, I need to dissolve in a glass of water 50 grams of magnesium sulfate. Magnesium sulfate is a very wild thing. It's very salty and it's almost impossible to drink, but it's necessary. Prepare a glass of clean water to wash down this disgusting thing. I think a liter of vodka is easier to drink than this magnesium sulfate. Point four, next step. Lie on your bed without pillow. The surface of bed should be flat. You are lying right on warmer on your right side, pressing the place where the liver is located. Who doesn't remember where our liver is located? It's in the upper right part of abdominal cavity, right behind the ribs. Be careful not to get burned with warmer. And you should be lying in this position for an hour, drinking only clean water. Point 5. After an hour, you begin to move actively, walk around, doing your home things or whatever you want. And in an hour or two, you will see what will start happening. You will be defecating like a bear after hibernation, and you won't be believing in your eyes how this pile of shit has been walking with you all this time. But just relax. Enjoy this time. Don't be afraid. You should feel relief from cleaning your intestines. Here, I want to warn you. If you have some problems with gallbladder, and your bile channels, for example, have some stones or they're just blocked, you have very big risk of perforation of gallbladder. So it's better to make ultrasound and take blood tests for bilirubin in advance to be sure that you have no problems then. Point 6. Go to sleep when you feel like empty and there are no urges to visit your white friend anymore. Point 7. Wake up at 5 in the morning. You should make cleansing for 3 times using your new friend enema. Pour 2 liters of warm water inside the enema, not very cold, not so hot, comfortable for getting inside your colon. Dissolve 2 teaspoons of sea salt and 1 teaspoon of baking soda into the enema. Lubricate the enema tip with the oil and your anus as well. You can use petroleum jelly, it's especially for those who are using it at home every day. Release some water so that the bubbles do not cause any discomfort inside your intestines and insert the tip right in your anus. Fuck. The first times already after 15 or 20 seconds, there will be some urges to defecate immediately, but it's better to try to pour in as much water as you can. In any case, if you cannot tolerate pouring as much as possible, you need to do 3 enemas with 2 liters of water each for the first time. You can keep the water inside yourself, lying on your back, making some movements of the abdomen, helping the water to penetrate to the most secret places of your intestine. Or you can defecate right now. Here I'm leaving a space for creativity. In the following days of fasting, I've always been doing 1 enema in the morning and the second one in the evening and another intermediate enema if I'm feeling weak in the daytime. And enema washes away the toxins. It's very important because the purification process has started and you need to release all toxins from your body. And now I'm going to continue my own experience. First long fasting was 7 days without water, as I told you before, but I was making enemas and taking baths. And on 3rd day, some long, about 10 centimeters, transculent, yellowish things came out of my colon. I was shocked and I didn't expect these things. And I started to search pictures in the internet. And I won't be showing you them now, but if you are interested, you can ask Google to show you some helminths. These guys can be reason of your apathy, weakness, and irritability, yes. I felt myself super energetic and I was working about 6 hours a day. My feeling of cold left me. It was very strange. It was November, but I remember that I wanted to be on cold, extremely wanted to breathe in fresh air. I even made some sports on my balcony and it was around -5 degrees and snow started to fall. Also, I was sleeping with the open windows, wearing a wool hat on my head and socks not to catch cold. I was enjoying every breath outdoors. It was like natural drugs. Can you imagine this? Simply breathing made me madly happy. I can't explain this right now, but I want to tell you that it's really important to move, to walk during your fasting, do some sports to help your toxins leave your body. Dry fasting was very easy for me. My body was warm like a stove and I was sleeping maximum 4 hours a day. But the first acidotic crisis happened to me on 8th day when I started to drink water. I faced the awful headache as if I had the worst hangover ever. And after this followed 4 days on water, 4 days on natural fresh juices, maybe orange, I don't remember exactly, and then vegan diet, of course. I felt myself reborn and excellent, very pure like a child. Lost only about 4 kilograms all in all. But unfortunately, after this, some not very good things happened to me in my life, as usual, and caused disbalance in my psyche, and I started to smoke cigarettes and even drink alcohol, red wine, and my awareness wasn't at the highest level at that time. The second fasting experience was fasting for cure disease. It was a necessity. It has been 2 years since my first fasting and my body has been quite polluted. And I stopped being a raw vegan, I was only vegetarian, and I allowed myself some chemical shit. I suffered from the tonsillitis, but I couldn't stop smoking. But by the way, I finally gave up, and I want to share this experience, my method, how I gave up smoking too. At that time, I was resting on the sea and caught some certain bronchial infection. The doctor who examined me said that there were all signs of pneumonia. And she said me urgently go to hospital and inject antibiotics. And then I remembered about my favorite dry fasting and told her, no, thanks, I'm starting my fasting. And by the way, the doctor was very advanced and she said that she knew about this method and it can really help. But she suggested me to do photofluorography after my recovery. The body temperature was about 40 degrees. The cough was so strong that it seemed to me that I will spit out my lungs. And I remember the towel lying next to me on the bed and I spat it out with completely green disgusting mucus from my lungs. And I didn't do it anymore at that moment because there were no conditions for it. I knew from the books I read before that fasting is the best method of curing pulmonary diseases and diseases of a gastrointestinal tract. So my belief was very strong, although I was very, very weak. On the second day of dry fasting, the temperature dropped to 37 degrees, and it really was something serious, perhaps acute bronchitis. I drank water for 7 days and became very thin, lost about 6 kilograms. And I'm showing you these photos as an evidence. Here, I'm almost 27 years old and really I was close to joining this famous club of 27-year-olds. But on my birthday, on 11th day, I began eating fruits and did fluorography. And it turned out that my lungs were absolutely clean. That day I visited magical place, mountains, with insane healing energy and I felt a real relief. But soon after my recovery, my sister called me and said that father had cancer. Nobody knew what was the type and where this cancer was located. And the next 2 years were horrible for me and my father died from cancer of pancreas. When he was ill, I suggested mom to try fasting to cure him, but of course nobody wanted to take such risks and I had no right and responsibility for this as well. And the third type of fasting I tried recently. I just wanted to establish new mind state after my depression. You can watch my story, I described it earlier, and Kundalini Yoga saved me. And again, I remembered about this magical effect of fasting. But this time I've chosen wonderful technique devised by Marwa Aganyan. She is an Armenian naturopathic doctor, physician, biochemist with 45 years experience in medical and laboratory work. And I need to warn you, if you have any allergic sensitivity to some medicinal plants, this method isn't for you. In theory, fasting lasts for 21 days, but I've chosen for me only 11 days because I have no serious diseases to be cured ASAP. And the scheme is very simple. First of all, it's necessary to clean your liver by drinking magnesium sulfate. This procedure you already know. And what next?
What next?
All days of your fasting, you will be drinking only water and special cocktail, which includes the mixture of 13 different herbs. The list is here. You can stop video and take photo of this list. All these herbs in equal proportions should be mixed together in a glass jar or other 3-liter volume container. And then to make our cocktail, we are taking 2 tablespoons of Vicks mix per liter of water, pour boiling water and brew it during 20 minutes. After this, we filter the broth and pour it into a thermos or just leave it for cooling down. Before use, you should add 1/4 of lemon and 1 teaspoon of honey. And then you will be drinking this cocktail about 1.5 liter for a day. And when the time of fasting finishes, the gentle exit should be done, of course. Drinking only natural juices, grapefruit, orange, and on the first day it's better to mix it with water. Minimum 4 days you're drinking this juice to make the results stable. And then raw vegan food for several days. And step by step, finally you will be returning to your usual meals and feel the taste much more brighter than before, intuitively excluding chemical food, because your body, your house will be clean, and why you should fill it with trash again. Each day of fasting, I was making Kundalini yoga classes in the morning. I was cycling a lot and working on fresh air, and it's very important. You know, during this fasting, I made so many things that I couldn't do for a long time. And moreover, I was deeply concentrated in the moment and experienced something like flashes of light and illumination. You know, it's like everything become surrealistic, and I want to discuss this experience separately in the other video, but not today, because for today my story is finished. If you have any questions regarding these described experiences, please feel free to ask me in comments. I wish you health and happiness. The main thing is not harming yourself, your body and your soul. Stay true and kind. Subscribe to my channel for getting more videos and let yourself know something absolutely new. Love you, see you, already miss you. Bye.